Hi you there. Kamusta po? Puputol po lagi yung aking recording. Ibig sabihin, we are so abundant with ideas and inspirations to talk about na napuputol na naman po ako, no? Unlike with the other vlogs, no, that I could properly introduce and then I could properly also say goodbye for that portion and segment and vlog. Anyway, to continue on, guys. No, to continue on that, I have reference to the Kennedy Report. I want to acknowledge that YouTube channel, the Kennedy Report, hosted to and researched by Kennedy, Mr. Kennedy Hall. So I'm acknowledging the YouTube channel, Mr. Hall, because your material, your vlog is very much empowering on my part, not only with regards to information, but really to validify what I have initially found out, no, what I have initially discerned about things, no, about this communism thing. And so to recap lang, no, to recap what I have mentioned in the previous vlogs, in case you people just viewed this particular vlog of mine, is that Saint Lucia said that really the global communism is here to take down America. Not only America, America would just be a representation, people of the Lord God, having been a nation that is freedom loving, God loving, God fearing, no, and democratic, advocate state of democracy. No, when we say there is democracy, we value the very essence and principle and the very gift that's given by the Lord God to every human creation, no, which is freedom and free will, no. Na sa atin lang po 'yan binigay, not to anyone in the animal kingdom, no. So iba talaga yung tao sa mga animals. Human beings has soul and freedom and free will, while animals does not have a soul, no. They only have a soul while they are living, but once they die, wala na silang kaluluwa. Unlike with us, that's why we need to take care of our soul, so that our soul would go to the highest, you know, would go also to the kingdom of the supreme being, the creator of and owner of everything and everyone, no, in heaven, no. Let's aim for that. So, yung ano po, the message in the apparition of the Blessed Mother every 13th of the month, no, for several months, to the three kids in the Our Lady of Fatima. The last message daw po is really about nga, the infiltration of the communist group in every country and government, for that matter. They have fundings, they have secret agents. I do not know if in particular KGB and, as mentioned, CCP is directly connected, no, or is working for the communist movement, or they are like the FBI, Federal Bureau of Investigation. But anyway, based on the report of Kennedy Hall, Mr. Kennedy Hall, so the strategy is to infiltrate a country to push, no, try to push communism, and eventually the end result and product and consequence and the very aim of this group is really to take over, no, agawan, no, grabbing of possession, authority, and therefore of everything, no, to topple down the established already authorities, no, in personalities as well as the system, no, in our case democratic. Kaya mapapansin nyo, guys, talaga indicative really, sa Camarinesor na lang po, no, na hindi nyo ako tawaran, I mean, huwag nyo akong kahinanakitan. Ang dami dyan naiinis sa akin na bakit daw ang dami kong na-report sa 48, no, when in fact hindi man lang tinitingnan na ano bang nangyari sa akin, guys, no, people of the Lord God, na ako ay mapasensyang tao, guys, no, mapasensya akong tao, pero kaya nga parang saving grace naman din talaga itong pagiging president ni President Duterte, because accept it, no? Hindi man tayo perfect, ang daming kuring mga points na kinakatakutan ko si President Duterte. Pero napakagaling na isa-isa sa mga sa kanyang programa na naisasatupad, na isasakatuparan, no? Kahit pa hindi lahat ng complaints ko ay already solved at this time, may boses man lamang, no? Binibigyang empowerment as supposed to be written in the law, in the constitution, na may boses talaga ang bawat individual. Mayaman ka sa hindi, nasa government ka sa hindi, pantay-pantay tayo sa batas, diba? And therefore, kung sino man yung nagbabiolate niyan, dapat hindi rin, you know, although we have warnings, we should have, you know, stages for it. Pantay-pantay tayo sa batas. Kung sino yung tahasang gustong mag-violate, should also take the consequences, no? As penalized by the law. So yan po. Kung democratic country tayo, tingnan na lang natin sa media. If we did not have the social media thing, and then the 8-8 also, kawawa talaga yung mga tao, guys, no? Magpaparapasan siya tayo hanggang galit na rin si God. People are oppressed, people are victimized, people who are very patient, very loving, very lax in their rights and privileges with regards to also their security, ay kawawa po talaga in our society, no? Especially kung papasukan na talaga nitong may mga democratic movements, no? Napailalim, ay hindi pala democratic movements, communistic movements. Napailalim pa naman yan, guys, no? Secretive talaga ang paggalaw, pailalim. Kaya nga, hindi mo alam, no? Nagsasabing democratic tayo, pero what is the actions? What are the dispositions and the decisions, right? So anyway, so the strategies to infiltrate a country is, one, demoralize the population. We have the culture of death as conspiracy theory. One of the books that really attracted me in the convent, no, na naging mission ko na talaga, na-inspire sa akin when I went to the library of our convent, is one book entitled Conspiracy Theory, The Culture of Death, no, with regards to the population, abortion, you know, by the Antichrist group, no, several groups of this. Ang iba, yung isa, tinatawag nila yung sarili nilang religion, na in essence, hindi naman siya religion because there is no recognition of the true God. No, meron silang tinatawag na God na ang lahat ng direksyon ng kanilang efforts, pamamaraan, isip, no, is murderous, no? They are allowed to kill, no? Na in the law of the land, it's not permitted, no? Because it's illegal. No? It's a murder case in any manner. Euthanasia, abortion, and the ordinary murder cases are all murder cases, no? But in their group, it is being allowed daw. No? Sa akin ngang pananaw, if I would be able to talk with these people, I would just tell them that, okay, guys, do not confuse yourselves. Even in any religion, guys, ha? In any group, secret man yan sa hindi. Still, the law of the land must be followed, no? Na sana naman in every society, in every country, the law of the land is, you know, in connection and not against the divine law, the law of God, no? So ganun po, makikita natin kung democratic country pa tayo kung unbiased yung mainstream media, which I have experienced myself. Hindi, no? When you go to a media outfit, nag-aantay pa ng pera, no? Samantalang kung titingnan, they already have sponsors, advertisements. So, ano ba naman yung isang complaint, no? Na valid naman, may ebidensya naman. Hindi man lang pakinggan, guys, no? So, that's one big thing that I was able to see, no? Nasabi ko, hindi na to democratic ang mga practices natin. And we are counting years, ilang taon nang ganyan, na aware lang ang lola nyong ito because things happened to me, no, personally, na wala na yung parents ko. Indeed, when my parents was here, even after college na, parang everything is taken care of by my parents, and then we are respected by the people. This one thing I saw, that so much yung grace ng daddy at mommy ko na there is really some kind of quote-unquote protection at the same time respect from people, even from amongst relatives. So iba talaga din yung dating ng mommy at daddy ko, no? I could really see the difference when they left, no? When they passed away, nag-iba talaga yung lahat, no? With regards to treatments ng mga tao. So grabe din pala, no? I really thank the Lord God sa struggle ng parents ko to be really good, to be holy, no? Though imperfect, may mga pagkakataong away to death din, no? Super away na I even have to run away from home. Some things like that, guys. Pero in generality, God has shown me talaga that at least so much din yung grace ng daddy at mommy ko na both of them before they got married went through a lot, no? Yung daddy ko, ganyan, yung mommy ko rin, na anak sa labas, something like that, guys, na yung father niya nga yung may royalty blood from Spain. And then, you know, when they got married, allowed by the Lord God, they were empowered, no? Against their weaknesses, against their shortcomings, no? They were really empowered. Dapat ganun talaga yung marriage, guys. There is a sense of empowerment to do what's right and good, no? To be holy, to be upright, but not for illegalities. Because if illegalities and sins, yung empowerment yung dalawa, it means to say that you have created something like a syndicate, no? You are binded together to do evil things, no? To kill, to do illegal drugs, prostitution, no? Better separate pagka ganun. It's not the real essence of married life partnership, no? Kung ganyan. So anyway, yun ang naka-trigger po sa akin na tumingin, no? That in the mainstream media, no? Radio man or television, may discrimination, no? You will not be attended to if you don't have money. Kasi hindi man tayo directly linked sa communism, people of the Lord God. It's clearly written in a, sabihin nating, blueprint ng communism. Na communism is just one example, an offshoot of a group that does not recognize and acknowledge and love and honor and respect that there is really a creator, no? Who owns everyone and everything, no? Who could see everything. So, it's anti-Christic, okay? Kung meron man yung magsasabi dyan na, hindi naman kami communist. Pero yung ways nyo, the way you speak, the way you think, the way you decide on things, and the way you do actions, no? Is directed towards that direction, no? That you do not recognize the Lord God. Because the Lord God is just, no? He is loving and merciful, but He is also just. So, example, if you are LGU barangay, if you are a government office, the objective of your office, example, is to regulate this and that, no? That no building will have to be built without the proper process of papers, without the proper approval of the design, without, nobody could build without, you know, owning the land as evidenced by a registration or building permit number, no? O ano ba yung nasa isip mo? Kasi hindi mo yung tinupad. Ikaw yung opisina, you are the ones employed there, you are receiving salaries, and these are the rules. Why is it that you are not able to comply with it? No, even if complaints have already come, it's more than being negligent on the job. It's more than being lazy, no? You are making a nuisance out of your position, no? Ang dami-dami po. So, makikita nyo na yung, ano, pagiging, it's a form of harassment sa mga citizens na alam ng citizen when they approach you na ito yung opisina nyo, di ba? Ito yung dapat nyong ginagawa. Pero in the end, ang makikita mo, they move in such a way that they will be favored personally, no? Personally. So talagang makikita nyo, guys, kung ganun ang panuntunan ng isang opisina, wala talagang makukuha yung mga citizen, no? It is malfeasance of duty altogether. Pero kung ang dami na, and it has been a practice for several years, parang ikaw na yung weirdo who demands for good behavior sa mga opisina, then we are not a democratic city, municipality, you know, district, province, region, nation as a whole, kung ganun ang ginagawa na talaga generally, no? Those, you know, nitty-gritty things would really tell us what is really in the roots, what is really in our system. Opisina nga, pinahihirapan mo yung mga citizen. Ano ka? Communist? Kasi sa communist country, guys, ganun. Pinahihirapan yung mga constituents. You only have like mechanics of what you do every day. Sinabihan ng City Hall, o bakit ang mga reyna at prinsesa dyan, eh ang mga muchacha ng city. Diba? You regard yourselves as queen and kings and princess. When supposed to be, even in businesses, in the quality standard that we call, the real queen and kings in the proper mode and manner are really the customers, no? Not really the abusive customers, but the clients. Your objective is really to satisfy your client and customers in the most legal way possible. Diba? So, if you satisfy that area, you are a winner. You have production. In the same manner that in every government office, no? Local or national in nature, you would say that you have achieved something in a day. If meron ka nagawa, akma doon sa objective ng opisina mo. Diba? Example, if you are the commission on audit, on a daily basis, have you thought of, you know, really checking randomly on a surprise visit? That's what we call in accounting and auditing a surprise audit, because you will not catch the, you know, the criminals and the thieves if you will not do them in a rather surprise manner, diba? My tito, who was also an auditor, a certified public accountant, used to be good auditor from Sisip Goras and Velayo CPA firm, auditing firm in Makati City. And that's from there he was able to, you know, come up with his own company. The people, some of the clients that they had, trusted my tito. He was really a hardworking animal, quote and quote, no? So doon nag-umpisa yung you know, na naging billionaire yung tito ko, the hard work as an accountant and auditor. Anyway, so yun po ang nakikita ko diyan, na yung objetivo ng opisina that you are in, you cannot even deliver. No, pahihirapan mo yung mga clients mo, yung customers mo. So what are you doing in the office, no? And it's really very vexating, guys, no, na alam na mga tao na yung opisina ang pupuntahan nila, ito yung, you know, this is what you're gonna get in this office, no? Assistance, building permit, or if complaints, ano lamang yung solusyon, di ba? So, if you do not deliver those things, no, and you do not show interest man lamang, no, to help out the client and customer, what are you there for? Kung nagiging kang nuisance, nagiging kang troublesome by not delivering your job or by delaying unnecessarily, you know, your job to the clients and customer, you are like communist, kasi ganun yun. We are using the term here, communist, in a rather general term, pero ang sinasabi po kasi dito, yung mga acknowledgement kay God, no, who dishonors the presence and the reality that there is a creator, no? And therefore, it's so easy for you to disrespect anyone, no? To go against what you were made for, to go against the yoke that you have taken, to go against the duties that you have freely taken for yourself. Example, as a mother, as a father, as a student, as a politician, as a government servant, rather than a government officer, no? It would really help you guys if you would put it in your minds that in the government offices, you are servants only. Servants who have motherly and fatherly heart. Because otherwise, if you really regard yourselves as, you know, superior, you will be abusing, you know, the trust and power given to you to supposed to be, to serve the people, not to abuse and misuse and, you know, to steal from the people the resources. So yun yung ano, yung kino-continue natin na messages from the Fatima Center, na yun ang sinasabi na sa message, no, ito yung secret message talaga sa Fatima, no, na, yung iba kasi na-expose na siya, nangyari na, and then na-solve naman. Pero ito po kasing last na about the communism. Sinasabi po, no, based on the Kennedy report, na hindi po natin na-achieve to consecrate Russia. No, Russia is happens to be the seat of communism too, no. Very strong po yung communism doon. At syempre pangalawa po yung China. They're really practicing it. So sinasabi sa Kennedy report, the sad story that we were not able to achieve to consecrate Russia. Nakulangan po tayo sa obedience, no, sa mga direction ni Blessed Mother for penance, penance and penance, and the recitation of the Holy Rosary, no, meditation of the mysteries in the life of the Son of God, Jesus Christ, in our midst, no, the Son of God. Nakulangan tayo, obviously, in the Catholic Church with all those direction of the Blessed Mother. And recently, no, after the apparition in the Our Lady of Fatima, we also have this apparition of Jesus Himself, the Divine Mercy, to Saint Faustina Kowalska in Poland, no? That Jesus said that this is the last devotion and the next stop would be really the judgment day, the end of the world, no? So, before the divine wrath and judgment and justice is the divine mercy. I believe, my dear brothers and sisters, that despite of the reality that we have reached also the catastrophic chastisement of the Lord God with this pandemic, no, and disaster here, disaster there, no, diba nakita naman natin eruption dito, eruption doon, tsunami, flood, typhoon, no, strong winds, cyclones, etc., etc. We are still given by the Lord God a chance, no? I would still speak about hope. Pero sinasabi ko na po sa inyo, yun ang answer po sa akin na Lord God when I was telling Him that I am so scared already, Lord, no, na yung ambulance by our area is like almost on a daily basis po coming from the north going to the Bicol Medical Center, no, patients who are being rushed to the hospital, whatever is the illness, it means to say that those are emergency, you know, life and death situations. Ang naging answer po sa akin ni Lord God is really justice. Because like in 2016, I've exerted effort talaga. 6 years after He appeared to me in our farmland in 2010, that's the time that He has inspired me. So, hindi ko po alam. I was not updated po. I don't have a Wi-Fi. I was not updated what's going on in the Catholic Church because it seems to me that everybody, you know, shunned away from me. Na noon, updated ako kasi I am in the religious community. I was also in the media, no, radio. Masyado po akong kinast away ng community ko for, I do not know, evil reasons, obviously, no. Yung mga kalasungan kasi dyan. Yun din ang naka-topple down, guys, sa pagkabanal ng community where I used to be. Yung kalasuan ng mga babaeng lumapit, no? Mga prostitute na nagmistulang, nagpretend na mga banal. Hindi na nakita ng mga pari, no? Na slowly they were, you know, eaten up. And I bet, I will not wonder if some of them has really links also with the communist group. Because they really want to establish, no, and create sinful society. Therefore, they want to attack people who has the light, no? Yung mga people who are struggling to be holy and to be upright and to be pure and that is our community before, no? Yung mga kabatch ko, hindi ko alam yung mga shenanigans nila, pero ang alam ko, most of us before were really very simple, trying to be pure, you know, struggling at least to be pure and humble and simple, no? In the society, until evil women came. Communist-linked and evil prostitute women came to the community. And whether they admit it or not, guys, the humility and purity that was entrusted to the community in the devotion to the Blessed Mother, the Immaculate Heart of Mary, through the Franciscan spirituality in the life lived by Saint Maximilian Maria Kolbe, who was the saint of charity, no? The opposite happened, guys, after that one. Especially nung umalis lang ako ng panandalian. Yun ang sinasabi noon ni G. Bajola, no? Ni Veronica Bajola, na nagsalita siya ng katotohanan patungkol sa akin. Now, wherever I go daw, I think including the community I was with the Franciscans of the Immaculate. Pag umaalis daw ako, guys, nagtitake over daw yung devil. Ayoko pong tumawa sa ganyan. Pero in my part kasi, parang a little bit, I have to be honest, a little bit I was flattered, no? Na ganun yung statement niya ni J. Bajola noon when we were having a meeting. Na kung umaalis talaga ako, guys, yung lalo na pag kinick out ako na with disrespect, really the devil gets inside. Siya po ang nagsabi niyaan. Kaya nagkakaroon ng trouble and turmoil. Hindi naman po sa pagyayabang. When I joined the tertiary, I was really, you know, handpicked by the superior then, Father Giancarlo Maria Rosales. Because that time, I was already, you know, gonna be accepted in the first level in the Opus Dei. No, it means to say I did good, no, in the 1 year of formation while working in an IT company. I emailed him, no? Dapat kasi hindi na. Pero he was kasi my original spiritual director eh. So I emailed him that I am being invited. Yung pala in this Opus Dei community also, not everyone is, you know, kumbaga, it really applies that many are called but few are chosen, no? I was one of those who were chosen and invited to by my spiritual directress, no? Na mag-formal na daw akong member. I was happy, no? I was happy because I really felt comfortable also with the community. Parang akma sa way of life, sa life that God has given me being a professional, no? A working person. No, we were allowed actually really to put on perfume. Of course, because you're working, I'm even, you know, advised to put on makeup. The simple things na baliktad naman kasi sa tertiary, no? Na hindi naman din naiisip yan minsan ng mga priest noon na dapat balance sila. That working tertiaries should still be, you know, made up, no? Kailangan pa rin na may perfume, kailangan pa rin ng ganyan. Not really to brag, not really to attract men, but, you know, as called for being working person, no? So, akmang-akma sa akin. Plus, imagine to that, guys. The founder is Saint Jose Maria Escriva de Balaguer, you know, Espanol. No, really, when the first time I went to, specifically in the University of Asia and the Pacific, where it is being run and managed to by the Opus Dei community and the Holy Cross priest. That's what they call the priest in Opus Dei community. They are really very formal, very systematic, orderly po talaga. And then at the same time, talagang pinangangalagaan, guys, na yung pari talaga, be away from temptation. In the same manner that the penitentio and the confessee and counselee will be also protected, no? With the very nature of being man and woman, no? Man and woman, na hindi ka pwedeng magkausap sa pari if you are not inside the confessional, no? Those simple things, really, you know, I have appreciated it to be well thought of, no? Anticipating temptation, no? yung mga pamamaraan nila, they really give you time. When you go to confession, you could really, you know, upload everything that's in your mind and heart, no? And then after that, you will receive for yourself good direction, not only consolation, but really good counseling, no? Alam ko na, nadala ko doon yung inaanak ko, yung pamangkin ko noon, tsaka yung twin brother ko sa University of Asia na Pacific, no? In the Stella Maris Oratory. 30 minutes would be my minimum for confession and counseling. Plus, guys, hindi lang sa pari. You have your own spiritual director or directress na who could also, you know, make kalkal, no? Ida-dissect niyan yung way of life mo every day. And that's where they would, you know, enter the moral stand to the angles in your life. So far, yung center na yon really gave me good formation. For me, they are A-okay. But ang alam ko, meron din po sa Legazpi na a shot also. So, depende, no? Kasi wala naman silang center doon, ang alam ko. Dependent na sa laxity ng taong nandoon. It's really a shot, guys, no? Ang alam ko. They were one of those also who had the relationship with the priest, no? Sexual in nature. So, I hope the Opus Dei community would check on them. Pero yung talaga napuntahan ko, guys, it's really St. Jose Maria Escriba also with my ancestry in the Spanish lineage of royalty. Kasi pag upo ko lang doon, pagbasa ko pa lang sa university, parang there was a message within me that you are home, something like that. That even if I do not know anyone there, as if everyone knows you, you know, spiritual, ano, the spiritual connectivity that we may call. In fact, some my roommate in AIM before and some of her classmates from ICA, no, Immaculate Conception Academy, mga Chinese, I was able to ask them to come with me there. No, yung iba, mga 10 years ang hindi nag-confess, 10 years ang hindi nagsisimba, they were helped, no, they were helped. Even some Christians, no, mga nadala ko doon for counseling and confession, and they were really helped. After that, they had direction in their lives, no. But not all. It depends. Talagang in everything naman, guys, talaga. It's a personal thing, no. Kahit pa sinend ka sa the best school in town, the best school in the country, if by yourself you do not exert effort, no, to sharpen your craft, sharpen your profession, sa'yo pa rin yan. So everything talaga would be really in a case to case basis, no. It's really a personal thing. Kahit pa napakayaman mo, kahit pa, you know, all those things, even in one family there would always be a difference, no, based on your personal disposition, personal training, personal decisions, no. So anyway, so ganyan po, guys, no, na ang mga strategies daw to infiltrate a country, yung demoralization ng population, yun creating fake news, no, creating fake news para ma-demoralize yung mga tao with regards to a leader. That's pretty much happened to in the United States of America to President Donald Trump. Nakaupo pa siya. Alam nyo, guys, ito nga yung analysis ko, eh. Nakaupo pa si President Donald Trump. May mga ginawa na itong grupong ito. Just like what happened to President Duterte also, di ba? Sa grupo ni Robredo, Ontiveros, you know, Kiko Pangilinan, etc. That also happened in the USA. President Trump na tinuligsa ni Secretary Nancy Pelosi, ni Harris, ni Biden, etc. Who is also one group, no? So, pare-pareho, guys, no? They made up actions to demoralize the population by making up stories, by, you know, overly doing small stories about what happened, no? Because eventually, they want to take over, no? They want to take over. So, those are the tenets of demoralization, no? Making up stories, making fake news, diba? Yung ginawa nila Robredo, eh. Bombarded, you know, mainstream and social media with, you know, hula balus. No, even that ISO is a scam daw. It has reached my knowledge, no? ISO ng VP office. So, yun. Natakel natin yung labor unions, diba? Labor relations and, you know, trade unions na yung, may I repeat lang, na labor unions and trade unions are mandated by the law. I could remember when I was working with Ayala Group, no? Specifically, Ayala Land Incorporated, no? As an accountant, one of the member of the accounting unit, although contractual pala ako that time, we have dues and fees for labor unions, no? So it's not only social security dues that we pay and also the BIR tax, income tax fees that we are being deducted upon with our income, but also the labor unions fees, no? Mandated po siya ng law, pero pag pinasukan ulit yan ng lies, no? At inabuse yan and misuse, it becomes what? You could see that it is being used as a communism strategy to topple down, no? Gagawa ng kwento para, you know, always attempt to topple down and destabilize the company. The company, and then of course destabilizing the capitalist and the owner or partners who established the company, no? So yun, paulit-ulit kong sinasabi, diba, sa Marxism there is always half truth and lies, kasi nga yung devil nga yung ginoglorify, so the devil is prince of lies, no? May half-truth and they would play around with it, no? Creating confusion, no? Creating trouble, therefore losing opportunities for those who are upright, no? For those who are already there, established and working, for the companies already there, no? So they would play around with it, and then, you know, even sometimes troubles comes and, you know, it causes lives, opportunities, you know, progress. Wala silang pakialam, guys. So, for you people who are thinking, no, who are attracted to join, mag-isip-isip kayo. Gusto nyo ba yung mga ganyan na ayaw ng progress? Okay na nga yung sistema. Konti lang yung nagugutom. At kung patuloy yung progress, ay talagang na-eradicate yung poverty. Sa kanila, hindi pwede. Gusto nilang sila yung mamumuno. So, hindi pwede. Kahit may progress, kahit may nakikita kang positive things, ayaw mo kasi ikaw yung gusto, no? You want to take over. Kaya gagawin mo yung lahat through the fire. Susuungin yung lahat. Ibibenta yung katawan. Ibibenta yung kaluluwa, no? Para maalis yung nasa posisyon. That's what Secretary Garin, no, did to the Department of Health. Na in the end, anong nagawa ng babaeng yan? Murder cases of kids who availed of the anti-dengue vaccines. Ongoing po yung kaso niyan na ginagawa at, you know, trying to be solved by the public attorney's office in Manila. Yun ang nakita ko po dyan, oh. Mga babae pati, guys. Kaya nakita nyo yung inspiration ni God, yung mga, some of my vlogs, no? We were talking about the essence of womanhood, no? Because women could really use their, even their bodies, no? Their faces, their alindug, to break the law, to break the graces of the Lord God. That's supposed to be overflowing to the society, to their families, no? Just to obey Satan and the princess of hell, no? Isang example ko po yan sa Secretary Garin, na sabi ko nga nung time na yon, ang pagmumuka ng babaeng to. Sorry guys, ha, that's how I really think and saw it. Nagagalaiti ako na talagang may nangyari, no? Hindi ko rin kasi alam kung paano ko sasabihin, no, na feel ko na ganun. Para noon si Lala namin na cousin. Inis na inis din yan dyan sa mga miyang yan. Meron din siyang ganun sa akin, guys, no, na kahit hindi pa namin kilala yung tao. Ganun yung feeling namin, no, na parang may anticipatory na foresight of feeling that they are gonna do something bad. So, itong si Secretary Gary, nakita ko na po ito noon pa lang. Sabi ko, kasi, ano siya, ano yan, sukdulan namang manira doon sa previous na secretary, matanda na, lalaki. That's what they're doing to President Trump and President Duterte. No, these women. Kumbaga, disrespeto, guys. Because they don't have Christ in their heart. It's really Satan that's in their heart. No, so, their bodies are also, you know, subjected to the wants and desires of Satan. Kaya, very open po yan mga ganyang babae, guys. Talaga. You will not wonder. They are worse than prostitutes. Yung katawan nila yung ginagawang capital. No? So, yun din ang lumalabas, diba? With Harris, this Representative Congresswoman Cortez in USA. So, this one, napakalaking, ano po, hindi ko naman ma-blame yung sarili ko na hindi ako nagsalita those times about this Secretary Garin. Because, first of all, I don't have YouTube channel that time. Secondly, I do not know her that much. I do not know how to express, no, a foresight, no, a hunch. Na totoo nga, may ginawa siyang mali. I wanna raise up, guys, no, to glory the former secretary ng Department of Health before Secretary Garin. He was really a victim of toppling down by this evil woman, no? The former secretary was humble enough. Kasi kung hindi rin humble, guys, yung previous secretary, siguro kinasuhan pa yung Secretary Garin na yan. Kasi kung ano-ano yung ginawang kwento, guys, in accusation to the former secretary. And indeed, that was one momentary victory of this communist group, evil woman. She was able to get the position. No? She took over. Kasi iba naman baga, guys, halimbawa yung mga kagaya namin, by observation lang, social media information forwarder and social media analyst, no, political analyst that I may call myself, and information forwarder lang, no? Iba naman kasi kami, I do not take interest to take over, no? If there'd be a will of the Lord God na may pinapacheck sa akin at pinapausisa na may mga evidences naman, tapos yun ang gusto ni Lord God, then I'll take it. Pero yung puntiryahin ko, guys, yung isang tao para lang palitan, that's not in my system, guys. Hindi talaga ako maingitin at hindi kontento ako kung ano yung bigay ni Lord God. Kung may gusto ako, I pray over it, no? I wanna get it in the most legal and unsinful manner. Unlike with this communistic strategy, no? Maninira, no, to topple down the person and then they would take over. So yun ang ginawa po ito nito ni Garin. Yun ang ginawa nitong Secretary Garin na to. At yun, murder ng mga kids ang kinalabasan ng paninira ng babaeng to. Let's admit it, no. Quote and quote, there is a temporary victory na accomplish niya yung kagustuhan ni Satanas. Na nag-take over siya. Ang dami pong mga issues also of scam and corruption. Plus death, sacrifice, ginawang sacrifice yung mga buhay ng mga taong, yung mga kids, no, na naturukan ng Dengvaxia vaccine. Kalimutan ko na naman, guys. Ano ba yung sakit na Dengvaxia yung supposed to be yung cure? Forgive me, guys. Talagang nagkakaroon ako ng mga ano ba? Nagiging makakalimutin ako because of, you know, stress din and kung ano-ano mga experience na napagdaanan natin. Anyway, alam nyo na yon yung illness po na supposed to be makocure ng Dengvaxia vaccines. But instead, it has annihilated a lot of kids, no? Yan po ang resulta ng evil intention nitong Secretary Garin na ito, no? So the likes, mga ganyan po, no? So there is half truth. They play on with lies. And you know, there was an example given by Kennedy Hall, no? That in Quebec, Canada, there was a labor union for the electricians, no? And then merong half truth na ginawa yata. So hindi na pagbigyan yung mga electrician. And imagine, guys, that the electricians are very needed in Quebec, Canada. In Canada, no, and in other countries wherein they have the four season, no, they have winter. So during winter time, electricians are really very very much needed for the heater, no, heater systems, no. Sometimes you cannot be assured what if the heater system went wrong. So you need electricians in the homes, no. They should be on call, no. So nangyari daw po ito sa Quebec, Canada, na yung electricians were not given with their wants, no, their request and demands. So nag boycott yung mga electrician. Ay marami daw po namatay kasi nga kung may mga houses na hindi nga nag-work yung heater nila. So walang electrician na matatawagan because of that, no? Because of that. So anyway, so yung nangyari sa USA, we could really see, no, the symptoms of the communist attacks and secret, you know, taking over moves, no? The Russia collusion is one big factor, no? The Russia infiltration, no? I could remember newscasting, no, news about the 2016 election, the election that happened, no, during the time of Donald Trump, na merong wiretapping, etc., ng Russia. That time when I was newscasting, I was like, ano naman kinalaman nung again, I was in the point there that I just read the news there before we newscasted. So, ibig sabihin, I don't have so much background, no? That was my first few days. So, wala pa akong research masyado. Mas maalam ako noon sa local, ano, sa, medyo sa local news, especially in Naga City, that time. Kasi nandun yung focus ko sa social media research ko. So, I was thinking already that time, guys, when I was newscasting for lunchtime, no, for the foreign news, in particular, USA, with the help of Sir Neil and Kuya Joe. Naisip ko na yun yung news na yun. Sabi ko, ano naman kinalaman ni, you know, ni Putin, no? Vladimir Putin. Doon sa USA na may wiretapping, no, the security of the USA is obviously hacked, no? How could Russia be, you know, meddling in any way, in any affairs, and in any areas in the United States of America? So that is what they call already the Russian collusion and Russian infiltration, no? Napapag-alaman na daw po na itong ang president ng, what do they call this one, Prime Minister of the Soviet Union, no, Putin, used to be a KGB agent, no? Okay naman sana yan, naging siyang, you know, investigation agent before he became the leader of the Soviet Union, Russia, no? But he is using already his skills, no, to infiltrate in other country, therefore creating trouble. At pinapakita po sa akin sa vision that he has been, you know, riding on his personal jet plane, you know, to go from one country to the next. Yun nga, kasi their attempt, no, their attempt to really take over in countries that are non-communist. No, grabe po ang ginagawa ng grupong ito. Sumasakay-sakay siya lagi. He frequently travels, no? And they could just enter into any territory. Of course, with inside job partners. Kaya, huwag tayo masyadong tiwala, guys. I mean, you know, wala pa dyan yung China, guys, diba? Kasi, yung China started to fire missiles against UK, United Kingdom, you know, ships, as well as the US military ships that has been in the China Sea. Although, meron naman silang right na magganon kasi territory nga nila. Pero to fire a missile like that, na wala malang pakundangan, no? Medyo war talaga yung, ano, yung hinahanap nito. And, diba, China troops has been, you know, has entered the USA pretty much like how it is in the Philippines. No, yun, doon ako tinutunig sa nang dati kong lawyer din na kapatid ng kaibigan ko. No, I will not mention his name. He is now abroad. Ngayon ko lang attorney na nakita na you were concerned about me. No, I was really like arguing with him. Hindi ko alam yung kasi kahit po ma-research yung lolo nyo dito, syempre, may limitation tayo, di ba? A person could just do as much, no, with the limited time that we have. And I get so tired also sometimes. Syempre, matutulog ka, magre-rest, no? Not naman all the time nagre-research ka and doing something. So, hindi ko na cover yung area na yan, na may mga Chinese nationals nga that entered, you know, surprisingly with great number in our territory, no, military and non-military, was able to enter. Yung pala yung pinapoint out ni attorney, no, doon sa pag-uusap namin, because I've been like defending President Duterte. Pero sabi ko naman sa kanya, hayaan mo, hindi ko kasi alam po yung area yan. Let me study about it. Let me, you know, gather materials for me to get to know about these things. Pero ang alam ko lang po kasi, attorney, ganito ganyan, no, na meron naman siya mga magagandang accomplishments, ganito ganyan. Tapos yun pala, napag-alamanan niya po, no, ng lawyer na to who tried to help me before. And is really has helped me. Kaya lang wala na siya dito, no, nag-migrate nga yung family niya abroad. Because he also came from that country, no? He fell in love already with the kind of system they have there. So, he decided to go back there, no? He was a scholar, I think, in one of the universities there. So, anyway, he was really like fighting with me. Sabi ko, are you okay? Kasi he used to be really like cool. I could not imagine him like ranting, no? But ang naisip ko na lang doon, pinagpasensyahan ko siya, guys, hindi ko siya pinatulan because that was kasagsaga ng umpisa ng lockdown, no, the quarantine. Everyone is still pretty shocked. Everyone is like, you know, traumatized, no? Traumatized. Wala naman tayo dyan mapipili. Abogado man, doktor, accountant, pari, bishop, all of us were not ready of this, you know, chastisement that I may call. Yung pala, guys, may nakikita nga siya na ako nga ay delikado, no? Like, there were really death threats to me. And siguro, nakikita niya because it's from the part of the government. Ang alam ko from, of course, those are from the group of Robredo na wala pa yan sa position or not. Masama na yung intention sa family namin being landed, no? Na may link nga ito sa communist group si Robredo having... Ewan ko kung paano nila, ayoko nang magsalita dito, no? Kung paano niya yan nakuha, yung pagiging komunista, no? Pero pailalim, they would always deny those things, guys. But the way they speak, the way they conducted their affairs, holding offices in the government, and the way they behave, no, with the reports that was given to us, you could pretty much theorize or even conclude, no, that it's really communist related and linked, an ongoing plot which is a global communism movement. So yun, so yun po, ito nga si Prime Minister Putin would frequently travel with in his private jet plane nung goes from one country to the next. So, napaka-active po, no? Napaka-active kung ano yung mga gusto nilang i-push, no? Kung papahintulutan sila ni God. So, yung Russia collusion and Russia infiltration in the USA are just one symptoms too of their communistic attacks. Ayan, na-mention na natin yung destabilization. It's happening already. It happened in the Philippines with a wealthy family, with private companies, with landed people. No? Pinangangalandakan nga daw po yan ni Robredo na yung sa family namin, successful daw siya, na may mga na-destabilize siya, sabay sa amin pa humihingi sa mga tonto-tonta kong mga relatives sa States. Doon pa siya nang hihingi, guys, no? Plus yung mga in-insight niyang mga created, you know, communities of squatters na sinasabi niyang hindi kayo maaano dito, no? Example ko na po yung ano, yung nag-run na vice mayor, no? Hindi ko na kasi nakikita si Kuya. Nag-work po siya dyan sa downtown. Na siya daw, isa siya sa sinabihan na ibibigay naman daw yung squatted area sa kanila. So, hindi ko naman yun hawak, no? I mean, nagkamali na si Kuya doon, no? Nagtiwala siya masyado kay Mrs. Robredo na paano yun ibibigay sa inyo, Kuya, kung hindi naman sa kanya yung lupa, di ba? Yun kasi yun. Kaya dapat, pag may nagpa-promise ang ganyan sa inyo, tingnan nyo yung validity ng sinasabi. Politicians could just, you know, promise you heaven and earth and even hell. Those are just promises, lies. No, pag tinignan nyo in the end, kayo na yung nasa trouble. Tapos ikaw, sasabihan ka pa niyan, uto-uto ka. Diba? Just like how it is with the devil in the judgment day daw. That's the time that they would reveal na uto-uto ka naman, no? Na bilib-bilib ka naman. Wala ka bang sariling isip? Wala ka bang sariling pang-usisa kung totoo yan or hindi? Diba? Tapos nag-aantay ka na sa wala. Ayun na, nung pumunta na nga yan sa VP office si Leonora, eh may mga pinagtawanan daw yan ng mga followers na hanggang laylayan lang kayo. Paano ba yan? Iiwanan ko na kayo dito sa, you know, sa Congress, tapos yung mga taga-Naga na ayaw ko na anya dyan magbalik. Nasanay na kami ng mga anak ko sa mga, you know, posh things. Malilinis, mabango. Sa Naga anya, mabaho. In fact, when Secretary Jesse Robredo was still alive, I've already mentioned this, that there was one feast season for Our Lady of Peña Francia na naka-check-in pa yung pamilyang yan sa Avenue Hotel, guys, no? Of course, my tita could afford, my tita Tito really comes to Naga for the devotion and the celebration. And checks in the hotel kasi wala naman sila ditong bahay, no? So they are, you know, kumbaga they are worthy to check in hotels like that after working so hard, no? Ay, naka-check in daw po yung pamilya, no? Taga dito naman yan, may bahay naman. So they have really lived a luxurious life, no? For public servants like that, may bahay ka naman, may aircon naman sa bahay mo. Why do you need to check in? No? Nakisawsaw pa, nakiagawan pa sa mga pilgrims, no? Coming from other countries, coming from other parts of the nation. Nakasiksik pa sa accommodations, nakulang nga. Sa time na mga ganyan, yung mga hotels, no? Lodging inns. Pag feast season and month in our city. Yun ang sinabi ng tita ko, nakita namin. So everyone was like making comment. What's wrong with their house? Why do they need to check in an expensive hotel? Kasi 3-star hotel po, baga yung Avenue Hotel. So, those simple observations of people, guys, would really tell you na corrupted talaga ang mga pinasasasaan na pera. If not from illegal activities. No? So yun po, ang gusto niyan mga communist movers or jump starters or head starters or spearheads na sila lang, no? They would enjoy kayamanan, sila lang, no? Yung mga common na tao, hindi. So, they want to destabilize mga successful people, people who are enjoying well-gotten wealth out of hard work, and already the wealth given already their years already is counting with a clan of royalty lineage, or in the case naman of the Marcoses, dati nang mayaman yung Romualdez at the same time the Marcoses, plus yung gold trading business that, you know, flourish from the successful profession of the President Ferdinand Marcos for being a lawyer, no? Na pinanalo niya yung kaso with regards to gold trade doon sa pamilyang meron ng mga gold, no? And as a reward and as payment, he was also introduced to that trading business. Years before, he took seat in the Malacanang Palace. Kaya, maling-mali yung mga accusations and made-up stories nila Robredo and other groups, no? Who is campaigning hate against the Marcoses. Kaya tayo guys, we need to clarify things. We need to research na ito talagang pamilyang to ay mayayaman. Ang worth po ng asset ng mga ng pamilyang ito is more than quadrillion. So, hindi lang sila yung matatawag na trillionaire. Quadrillionaire pa na biyan pa siguro, because the worth of the gold bars that they have, no, is already quadrillion. Something like 70 plus quadrillion. So, we're not yet counting the money deposits they have, the properties that they have, you know, stocks, etc., money placements, investments here and there, businesses they were able to establish here and abroad, no? It's more than that, guys. Kaya, yun po ang pilit na gustong itapol down ni Robredo for one, no, their group. Gusto niyang pantayan at lampasan pa. Hindi niya magagawa yun, guys, in this lifetime. Napakayaman po ng Marcoses out of good work and the grace that God has given this couple. Napakaganda po. They are a